Kamome Diner is a 2006 film written and directed by Naoko Okegame about a woman who has set up a diner to serve Japanese food in Helsinki, Finland. Many of Okegame's films are what is known as yashiki or healing films, which tend to be films that cultivate a genuine feeling of harmony, relaxation, and, as the name suggests, healing for the busy and often stressed people of modernity. As Japanese film expert Colleen Liard writes, Okegame's work are equally often characterized or criticized as superficially atmospheric and environmental, with emphasis on the surface visual composition over narrative depth. I would argue that in the case of Kamome Diner, the clear and simple visual composition carries more than just surface aesthetics, as she's able to frame the camera that captures a mise-en-scene that does a great deal in supplementing the main theme of healing in her narrative. This video essay examines the Okegame's use of glass window as a metaphor for those who are in need of visual healing as they gaze through the invisible barrier. As the film is titled Kamome Diner or Seagull Diner, the structure of the diner itself is rather important. The diner is surrounded by big, large glass windows and with very minimal decorations on the windows, which allows people to look inside and for the first half really have a gander at the lack of customers that dines within the diner. For the film, Okegame actually used just a pre-existing diner and decided to put her own furniture inside. As we take a look at the following four clips, the characters are shown to be staring from outside the diner through the glass panel window into the diner. Here we have the three Finnish ladies, previous owner of this location, Matti, spooky, scary old Finnish lady, spooky, scary old Japanese lady. Each of these four characters have their own distinct problems and their own distinct gaze. We can contrast the four we just saw with someone like Tommy Hiltonen, the happy weeaboo Finn who just never stopped at the window to stare inside because he doesn't really have much of a problem. He just waltzes right in from the get-go, basically, unlike all the rest of these four characters. Let's take a look at each of these characters that stares from outside the window into the window and examine exactly what their problems are and why and how maybe they were resolved later on in the film. First up, we have the three old Finnish ladies. These three stand outside the glass window to look in. The three's gazes are normally to gawk and to make fun of the people that are inside the diner, mainly the store owner, Midori, and their lack of customers. While their gaze into the diner might not be racist, but definitely shows a lack of understanding or willingness to understand the people from within the diner. It was until later when the smell of Cinnabons drew them in to the diner. The three often avert their gaze when locking eyes with Sachi-san, perhaps due to their gossipy nature and hollowness in their act. After the repeated gawking and judgmental gaze, the delicious Cinnabon quelled their biases, and they became a regular part of the diner. Secondly, we have Matti. As he initially walked past the diner, it looks as if it was rather perverse. He has this look into the diner and almost predatory camera angle staring into the diner. We later realized Matti was the previous store owner who ran a coffee shop before our main protagonist, and that Matti is there to scope out the store and eventually take back the coffee machine that was originally his. His gaze is rather greedy and self-centered, but eventually the staff of the diner came back, caught him, fed him rice balls, and gave back his coffee machine. And he just came back as a regular patron because his problem is solved and he is healed pretty much in this space. Before we get to the scary Finnish lady, Let's first examine Masako. After losing her luggages by the airplane company, she is lost in a foreign country that she doesn't really have any relatives or friends in. Her gaze is mostly for comedic effect and to perhaps juxtapose Lisa's near demonic gaze. Behind her stern look, Masako is lost and she willingly walk into the diner by herself because she wants inclusion and company after what happened to her from all the luggage and being lost in a foreign city. She was able to find company with the staff of the diner and eventually settle in as another part of the diner. So her problem is solved in this healing space too. Lastly, we have Lisa, who is angry and frustrated as her husband left her and she is just devastated and turned to booze for the most part. Despite her initial fierce anger, frustration expressed through her multiple visits and stern gazes, Lisa is eventually able to heal with the help of the diner staff members, as she just wants someone to talk to about her woes. She communicates her frustration through verbally, as she just wants someone to, you know, communicate. The two seemingly stern and fierce characters, Masako and Lisa, magically bond across language barriers, and she too becomes healed eventually, and her woes turns positively as her husband comes back and she become a happy regular at the diner. Each of these characters deliberately stare at or into one of these diners because they have a problem. The glass window as an invisible barrier is a rather obvious metaphor to showcase the lack of ability to connect with individuals on an emotional or human basis. Most of these characters who have problems just need a little bit more to understand one another. To look, to stare is to long for something that they don't have. Each gaze through the glass window is really just a plea for these characters to help them. We can think about it in terms of like therapy. Most of these people don't mean harm. They just don't understand. And their loneliness or anger, frustration, loss are most of the time a combination of stress for their own life and also the lack of understanding and connectivity with one another. This overall helps the narrative that this diner isn't just magical. It has perfectly real connotation that there are just people in the world that are willing to listen. Sachi-san is willing to give everybody a chance. She welcomes everyone in, and that's why it has a glass panel, and like she wants people to see inside her because she has nothing to lose. Whereas like some other stores, maybe they have more like frilly things or decorations. If you see, look at this glass panel, there really isn't much of anything covering it. And then we have these constant characters looking in, looking out of the diner, which really helps the fact that the healing process from Kanoe Diner is done through willingness to accept others and the simplicity of healing. If we refer back to the Iwake's Kamome Diner article, we can see that what is being depicted in this movie from the diner is, as she says, a image of simplicity, closeness to nature, sense of healing and warmth. That is imagery not unlike the organic pre-modern community. What Sachi-san wants from the diner is to establish ultimately a community. She welcomes everyone in. That's why it is a permeable barrier. It is not a barrier that is made of bricks, concrete. It's glass. Glass is malleable. Glass is see-through, and glass allows people to make connections from the get-go using one of their primary senses, which is sight. At the end of the film, we can see that the three main characters, Masako, Midori, and Sachi-san, looks into the camera lens. If we think about a camera lens, it's really just another piece of glass. After Sanchi-san is helping out all her patrons overcome their problems, she's looking directly at you, or us, the audience, asking us if we have any issues or problems with our lives that is dealing with anger, stress, and the permeability of perhaps film as a medium through that filmic glass, that Okegame wants us to know that it's really about the human sense of healing and warmth that will ultimately make us feel better, and the need for humans to make connections, to strive for a unity and community in our modern day busy and stressful life is what she wants to create with this diner. What we can take away from Kamome Diner and Okegame's simple yet effective visual composition and the use of glass is simply to sometimes stop, breathe, make contact with another human being, and form a meaningful connection, which ultimately is how we will be able to heal ourselves in today's busy modernity. Let us rewatch the ending one more time and learn from the diner staff to greet and connect through glass.
Sachie-san no irasshai wa ne, sugoku ii in desu yo.
そうですか？
確かにそうね。幸恵さんのいらっしゃいは見応えがあるわね。
ちょっとやってみてくださいよ。
いや、いいですよ。
いいじゃないですか。ちょっと見せてください。
いや、いいです。
こんにちは。
いらっしゃい。